Hello.
I'm
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening. My name is Karina Olette, and I serve as the principal at Grand Star Elementary. With the unique challenges in this school year, we have put a strong emphasis on our social-emotional needs of the students. We had the opportunity during our August professional development to look at what we already had in place and have continued to build on our current foundation. This year, when students arrive at school, they have a minimum of 3 adult contact points prior to the school day starting. Students are greeted in the car loop or when they get off the bus, during temperature checks, and then again by adults positioned in our hallway. This allows us the opportunity to have a positive interaction or pull students aside if they need additional support to transition from home to school. This is our second year at Grand Star to implement a morning meeting and incorporate social-emotional curriculum of Second Step from preschool through fourth grade. The responsive classroom morning meeting is an engaging way to start the day. It helps to build a strong sense of community within the classroom through 4 components: greeting, sharing, group activity, and a morning message. In addition to our morning meeting, teachers are presenting their Second Step social-emotional learning curriculum. This curriculum provides language and tools from perspective taking to calming down techniques. The units in each grade level all cover similar topics that build as students get older. The units include skills for learning, empathy, emotional management, and problem solving.
Eyes are watching, ears are listening, voices quiet. Bodies calm. This is how we listen. This is how we listen. At group time. At group time.
I can hear you.
Eyes are watching. Ears are listening. Voices quiet. Bodies calm. This is how we listen. This is how we listen. At group time.
Second Step developed a 3-week community rebuild unit this year to address the challenges students have faced in regards to COVID-19. We were able to review these lessons in August and present them in the first 3 weeks of school. It is exciting to know students have practiced these skills and are using these strategies in real life situations.
Good afternoon, everyone, or I should say good morning, everyone. Saturday morning here. You're on the campus of Gardner Edgerton High School here in Gardner, Kansas, where today the Trailblazers will take on the Owls from Olathe West High School. I'm Chuck Holmes. I'm here with Coach Larry Fennell. Morning, Coach.
Morning, Chuck.
Had your breakfast?
I have not.
I'm sorry. Maybe lunchtime here pretty soon.
That's right.
That's outstanding. You know, we got some changes to the schedule because of everything that's been going on with the weather. So pop that up on the screen real quick so people can kind of see where we're at and why we're here on a Saturday morning. You know, the frigid weather has caused some serious issues with the Trailblazers' schedule, forcing games to be rescheduled. The boys' game with Leftwards originally scheduled last Wednesday has been moved to the 22nd. And then the boys' game against Olathe Northwest has been moved to the 23rd. So, you know, weather does that to you sometimes.
That's right. We're fighting the weather and the COVID. So
yes, indeed.
We're making it work, though.
Well, within the last four games, the Trailblazers are 2-2. They've had kind of playing 500 here.
Yes.
You know, and that's this is crunch time.
Yeah, we're getting towards the end of the season right now, and everyone's jockeying for position. And, you know, you want to know where you're going for sub-state, but it's important to be playing very well at the end of the season, you know, to get maybe a shot at a state berth. You never know.
Exactly. This time you want to put you know, string together two or three victories to get some confidence as you're going into the tournament, things like that.
That's right.
You know, so each week, you know, we talk about a player. We're going to start again this week with number 22, Jake McClure.
But, you know, we've been talking about Jake a lot, and, you know, that's our Jake from State Farm right there. You know, Jake's been hot from the outside, and we got to make sure that we keep getting him that ball and let him fire up and have no thoughts in his head, just fire away. You know, we're going to need that outside shot from him, and it's going to help open things up in the middle for us.
Well, one of the things I like about Jake, you can never if he's off, his facial expression doesn't change. His attitude doesn't change if he's off or on.
Yeah.
He's a ball player that just, you know, he likes to play basketball.
Jake has the poker face, and you just never know if he's up or down, so you don't know which buttons to push on him. And we do know one thing, he will keep firing threes, actually.
Absolutely. Now we've got Ivan Jalobame.
Yeah.
Ivan's 6'1". He's a senior, and he's played very well the last two ball games.
Yes, he has. You know, it was unfortunate what happened in the last game, but other than that, before that technical foul, we're not quite sure what happened, but he was playing very well against those bigs.
Yeah.
And he was giving them a lot of trouble down low. And so, you know, we're looking for him to do the same thing today.
We need that inside presence. He's really stepped up his game the last few weeks, too. You know, and as we see here, he's hitting the board at 6'1". He's not afraid to get in there and battle with the trees.
He's not.
You know, he's tough, and he's got some quickness about him, too. So that's outstanding. We don't have much information on the Owls. We know they're 8-8. Didn't have a chance to really sit down and talk to the coach about their team, but there is one young man that used to be with the Trailblazers last year.
Yes.
And his name is Reggie Dennis.
Reggie Dennis,
yeah. He wears number 2. And you know, you don't leave the Trailblazers. Something's wrong.
Yeah, you never know why a player wants to leave where he's at. And you know, I'm pretty sure he had this game circled just as our Trailblazers had this game circled. You know, they know each other, and they're going to know what he likes to do unless he's done some off-season works. And, you know, he's going to know what we like to do over here as well because he was here. So
absolutely.
It's always tough when you have somebody come back.
Well, like you said, I'm sure both teams had these games scheduled on – have it circled on their schedule because, like you said, Twitter and TikTok and Facebook.
TikTok could get them.
I'll tell you, a lot of stuff going on there. We got our keys to the game as usual, Coach. We always have three keys. This game's no different. Key number 1, fast break points.
Yep.
Key number 2, get the ball to Ethan Reynolds. Ethan's been red hot lately, and then play strong, solid defense.
Yeah, Chuck, and all these keys are going to run together, and I'm going to just kind of go with it and let you know how this all works. So when we talk about fast break points, we're really talking about transition. Let's get out in transition. But in order to get out in transition, you have to play defense. So our third key is you got to play defense that gets in the transition, and also you got to get the ball to number 2, Ethan Reynolds. As we saw, Ethan got that last steal there. We get Kessler right here with this steal. But you got to speed the game up. So we got to play defense in order for us to speed the game up, in order for us to get the transition points.
Exactly.
Right? And in order for us to get the transition points, we got to find Ethan, who likes to take the ball to the hole.
Right.
So all three of those keys will go together. We look at key number 2 right here. Get the ball to Ethan. You know, Ethan's been hot. You know, we got to knock down some shots from the three-point line to pull that defense out a little bit, and we'll open those lanes for Ethan to get on the inside.
The one thing I like about Ethan is, you know, he's not the tallest guy in the world. He's tough. Yes. And he's quick, and he loves to play inside, if you ask me.
Yes, he likes contact.
He likes the contact.
Yes.
And so, and he's not afraid. And he's able to contort his body to different ways where he can actually make things happen.
Exactly.
So, you know, he's a key to the game also. Then there's key number three. Got to play solid defense.
You have to play defense, Chuck. If you don't stop the other team from scoring, you don't have an opportunity to win. You know, a lot of good coaches will tell you your team has to start on the defensive end. You must stop the other team from scoring, and then you have to score. But number one rule is play defense.
That's right.
Stop that team.
Well, we're going to talk a whole lot more about this during the game. If you don't have your pancakes, you better go get them now. If you don't have your coffee, you better go get it now, because we're going to be back here shortly with the starting lineups and the national anthem. You're watching GEHS-TV on MSTC Sports.
At Price Chopper, we know we're not the only grocery game in town. That's why we're always chopping prices. We're passing along the savings on our fresh cut meat. We're fueling your squad with affordable party trays and meals to go. And scoring you great low prices on all your game day favorites. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows Price Chopper.
And welcome back, everyone, to Gardner Edgerton High School, where our national anthem will be sung by senior Katie Bowman. I just talked to her before the game. She's a little nervous, but she'll be just fine.
She'll be all right.
Here's Katie Bowman singing our national anthem. Nice job, Katie. Had a little technical difficulties at the beginning, but you know what? We all know the words.
And we worked it out.
And so we worked it out. So, nice job, Katie. Thank you so much. Okay, now we're going to turn over to the public announcer for our starting lineup. Back here at Gardner Edgerton High School, Coach. Here we are, tip off on a Saturday morning. It's been a while since you've done a Saturday morning game.
It has been a very long time since I have been up on a Saturday morning watching basketball live in the arena.
Well, the Trailblazers start off in their signature man-to-man defense with the awesome Olathe West. We're going to have a foul right off the bat down on Ethan as he's trying to come across the top. It's kind of hard to see the Owls uniforms. Their numbers with the dark blue and the gray numbers. not doing the old guys any favors, man. Not helping us at all.
Yeah, they are making it tough on these old eyes up here to see what's going on.
This is true. And we really don't have a lineup for them, so we really can't say who's who. So we're going to concentrate on our trailblazers today.
That's right.
We do know number two.
We did highlight that young man earlier.
There's a long three-point attempt by number 10 who knocks it down. So the Owls jump out on top 3-0.
It's going to be interesting. It's going to be interesting to see how this game kind of unfolds with West taking that first three like that.
Yes, indeed. Giolabami goes up and gets his shot blocked. And we see Dennis running the floor. Misses. Giolabami hustling down, getting the rebound. Gets the ball out to McClure. McClure pushing the ball up the floor. Keister with the basketball. Stops. Sees Ethan. Ethan takes it in with the Euro step. Knocks it down.
You know, it's always good when we highlight someone and they come right out and show us why we highlighted them. And there it was. Ethan going to the rim as he always does.
Indeed. 3-2 Owls. We were tightly guarding. Another three-point attempt by the Owls. This is Mitchell. We have a foul on number 32 as he pushes Giolabami from behind.
Yeah, it was unfortunate. Long rebound like that, and you know he just was out of position. It's a good box out by Giolabami.
Indeed.
Manufactured that foul.
First team foul on the Owls. Ethan bringing the ball up the floor. Survey in the defense as the Owls are in a man-to-man themselves. Ethan trying to get the ball down low. Kicks out of bound off of the Owls' foot.
Let's see as Ethan gets that ball, yeah. He just split the defense. Defense didn't want to challenge him, and he split him and finished off.
Indeed. Here's Ethan again. With a little one-hander.
There he is. Ethan lives inside the paint, Chuck.
He lives there.
You know,
he loves
it. For a guard like that to live inside the paint, you know, you must love contact to be in there like that.
And that's got to make it tough on the opposing guard trying to guard him down low like that. They're not used to being down in there with the trees like that.
Exactly.
See the Trailblazer crowd starting to get into it early here in the first period. Good solid defense by the Trailblazers. They're forcing the Owls to move the ball around on the outside. Looking for the open man. Another three-pointer. No good.
Good box out. That's a foul.
That's going to be a foul there. Yeah. And Dennis, as Buttash was doing a good job of boxing his man out.
That's a good box out by Buttash down low underneath the basket. And you know, we had two-on-two going after the ball. Like that sportsmanship from the former players. And Dennis didn't intend to push him. It was just kind of happening in play. But yeah. That's good defense. That's what we need. We need to have that. We need to play defense and stop the other team from scoring.
Yeah, the Owls showing a little token backcourt pressure as Ethan slowly brings the ball up. Quickness again. Once it's up, throws the ball, it's knocked away from him, and here come the Owls. Dennis with the basketball, gets it over. Nice running layup for the Owls, number 11.
Yeah, he just got caught. Jake just got kind of caught on the hip, and you know, if you get someone on your hip, they say if he's on your hip, he's even, you're winning.
Yep.
So the guy with the ball always has an advantage if they're even.
He's with the basketball. He and Jacob, yep, there goes Jake. I was just going to say he hadn't taken his first shot yet, but
there it is.
There he goes.
There it is. Nice little pop-out screen. He runs up to top, gets that ball, and knocks it down. Jake. No hesitation whatsoever, Chuck, and that's what we got to need. You're a shooter. You don't hesitate to take that shot. And when that first one goes on, you think all of them are going to go in.
So Jake McClure with his first three-pointer in the game. Looks like the Trailblazers just dropped off and, they had gone to its zone. Now they're back to the man-to-man, looks like. Trailblazers are doing a good job of keeping the Owls from getting inside. They're forcing the Owls to take those outside shots.
Yeah, they're forcing them on those outside shots. Yep. And I believe number 10 is the guy they're really looking for outside of Dennis, number two. And
we're going to have another foul on the floor against the Owls. Here's Jake. Well, we see him at congratulating himself after the three-pointer.
Hey, we knew what happened. We saw it.
That's right. We saw it. We know it was good. Ethan with the ball. bring it over. Gets Buttash with it. Buttash looking for McClure. McClure's fake pump. And Joe Labame with the three. Joe Labame, that's not his game, but hey, it's surprising.
That's the first time I don't know if I've seen Joe Labame take a three at all, but apparently it's part of the offense because he was wide open. They look for him.
Yeah.
So maybe he's shown coach he can knock those down in practice and give you a shot in the game.
Trailblazers in the man-to-man. Nice pump fake, but number three gets down and low, gets shut off. Dennis with the basketball. He comes in, he drives, he forces the issue, taps it back up again, and tapped out by number 34. Back to the Owls as they reset their offense, but he's going to take a long three. It's going to be short. And Buttash with the rebound. Gets the ball off to Ethan, and Ethan pushing the ball to the floor. Stop. Jake, three-pointer. Just a little bit off.
That's a good shot, though. Transition three is a good shot. So
yep.
Just get a little short on that one. That's okay.
Yep, another three-pointer from the corner as Dennis was able to push the ball up.
Yeah, we're going to have to get back on D now that we don't have a scouting report on the West Isles, so we're going to have to kind of take a look and see. So that's two outside shots.
Keister with the three. He's short. We're seeing him running up and down the floor, Coach.
Running, running. Transition. You got to get going. It's Saturday morning. Wake up.
And Ethan steals the ball away. Here comes Ethan pushing the ball up floor. It's one on three with the no-look pass. The pass is knocked out of bounds.
Yeah, that's one of those passes. As a coach, the first thing you say is bounce pass. Bounce pass. Bounce pass.
I tell you, I love the way the dribblers are pushing the ball up the floor, though.
Yeah, I like it, too. It's, you know, we saw the last game that we did. When they got out in transition, they were pretty good out there. So, you know, we got to continue to do that as well.
And Malachi Taylor and Connor Elder checking in for Ethan Reynolds and Buttash. Keisha trying to inbounds the basketball. Gets the ball over to Connor Elder. And Jake McClure left by himself. You can't do that.
You cannot leave Jake open like that. He is going to knock those shots down 9 out of 10 times. And, you know, right now, we're going to see if the Owls can make an adjustment.
And we're all tied up here at 10-10. About two minutes left here in the first period. Mitch Mockers also checked in for Joe Labame, who's down low. He's patrolling the middle. 35 comes in, and he's going to be fouled. I think Keister going to get Keister with the on the arm.
Hey, Keister with the reach in, the old cookie jar.
Yep.
You know, they always catch the guy getting reaching in for the cookie jar, but they never catch the guy that's smashing the window.
That's what happens, man.
Yeah,
that's
I
what
understand
happens.
That, man.
And you don't even have to smash the windows. I mean, my sister and I. My dad, we should like banana pudding. I'd go and eat the cookies off because I didn't like the banana part. Didn't know my sister was doing it too. And she got caught. And she confessed to everything.
Yo, Chuck, you talk about banana pudding. I'm not a banana guy myself, but I love banana pudding. I don't need the bananas. They just don't work out for me.
There's the second free throw is up and good. So the Owls now lead 12-10 over our Blazers. Some token pressure as the Owls throwing a little bit of full court issue.
Yeah, I think the Owls are just trying to slow us down. They know we like to run, and you know, better way to slow down a running team than just give a little pressure to make them slowly bring the ball up.
Connor Elder with the three, and he misses from the corner.
It's a good look, though.
Yep.
It's a good look. Don't stop shooting it because you missed one.
Now we're going to have a foul on Malachi Taylor. As he reaches in.
Foul on 5 Taylor.
Watching Jake here knock these threes down, Coach.
No hesitation. Splash. That's how you do it.
That's right.
Don't think about it. Just let it go. Fire away.
That's what shooters do. And we're going to have another foul on the floor. The foul's going to be on. Make sure we call the foul on. Reynolds checks back up.
I think it was on.
He called it on Ethan. That's Ethan's second foul, so he's got to go sit down.
He's got to go have a seat. That's
that's big.
Yeah, that's a big loss right now. We need Ethan.
Tip back out to the Owls. Late the West. They're in love with the three-pointer. And if they can hit him.
So far, they're showing that they can knock it down. So we're going to change our defense and start working over the top of these screens a little bit and not allow these guys to get these open looks.
That's true. Malachi Taylor brings the ball up. Over to Butash. Butash looking for a little way in. Gets it over to Connor Elder. He sees Malachi. Malachi driving the lane. He's going to go up with the left hand. He misses. Jake Whitmock with the rebound. Elder thought about it, and he's going to throw the ball away because Mock was moving towards the basket.
Yeah, Mock was moving away, and they expected Mock to post up on that low block, and he was looking to go run a different play. So we're just not on the same page on that one. And it's early in the game, so yeah. It's okay to make mistakes like that. And everybody get on the same page, and we'll be okay.
Well, here come the Owls, maybe possibly looking to take the last shot of the period. They currently lead 15-10. Working hard down low. The 34 is going to go up with it with the running one hand. Got a little mismatch down there because Butash just didn't tall enough to contend with him.
Yeah, Licton knew that he had him, Butash on him, and he's got an advantage. And big guys, if you have an advantage, you always take it in.
Yeah, Lichtenstein's he's a low down in number 34. Malachi Taylor, fancy dribble, almost throws the ball away, gets it back down to 10 seconds. Keeser with the basketball. He's going to work it inside. Here he comes. Throws it back up. McClure with the three. Yes! Just short.
Just a little short.
Just short. Well, not quite what the Trailblazers had in mind at the end, but you know what? At the end of the first period, 17-10, the Owls from Olathe West leading our Trailblazers. We'll be right back after this break. You're watching GEHS-TV on MSTC Sports.
When it comes to higher education, Johnson County Community College delivers more for your money. More opportunities to learn outside the classroom, more interaction with caring instructors, more personalized attention with supportive student services. Discover more at JCCC. Change your life through learning. Change your life at Johnson County Community College. Call 913-469-3803 or visit jccc.edu to learn more.
Welcome back to Gardner Edgerton High School. Chuck Holmes here with Coach Larry Fennell. Coach, we've seen a track meet the first period.
Yes. Track meet is what we wanted, though. We want to run. We want to get out and run. And the Owls are just doing a pretty good job of just kind of slowing us down. They're not really trying to track. They're just trying to slow you down. But, you know, if I'm in that huddle, the one thing I'm saying is, hey, they're not trying to trap, but do not get caught in the corner because the jump trap is coming.
That's true. And Ethan checks back in with his two fouls. That's key. I hope that doesn't take away some of his aggressiveness. I don't think it will.
No.
Because that's just the type of person that Ethan is.
Exactly. He's an aggressive basketball player. He wants to go to the hole all the time, and he wants to mix it up and get his hands dirty.
You have to see Kellen Keeser press the issue. He's normally really good at that, too. He's shooting well over 60% from the field because he does get the ball inside, too. And there's Jake with the long shot. Miss. And Lichtenstein with the rebound.
That was
Joel Abone.
It was a good play to run out from my side of a timeout and get Jake a look. And it was a good look. He's just a little long.
They have a 2-3 zone. The Trailblazers are in. The Owls are trying to figure out what's going on.
Yeah, I think some of the guys know the play and some of the guys don't know the play.
Trailblazers are still daring them to shoot that outside three-pointer. Lichtenstein down low again. Turns, misses. McClure with the rebound. Gets the ball off to Butash. Butash pushing the ball up floor. Ethan Reynolds with the drive into the hoop. And he's going to be fouled as he goes in. Good job by Ethan, forcing the issue with two fouls.
Yeah, that's when you're on offense, you can really force the issue on offense, especially in transition. And, you know, the percentages of you picking up a foul when you have the ball in transition is lower.
Mm-hmm.
And if it is an offensive set, we got to knock those free throws down, Ethan. But,
short with
you
the
know, we got to continue to put that pressure on those guys. And if we can get some fouls on those big guys, and, you know, we'll make this even.
Yeah, that's misses both free throws. That's unusual for Ethan Reynolds.
That is very unusual for Ethan to miss both of those. And it's okay. Well, still early.
Still in the 2-3 matchup zone. Lichtenstein working hard down low with Joel Abone, who's got a height. He's at a height disadvantage.
Abone's working hard down there. He's keeping him out of that. Keeping him out of that paint.
In the 2-3 zone. I'm looking at that. That's great. Now you got a problem down. He's surrounded. Get the ball out. The Trailblazers are playing good defense. force the Owls to push the ball back outside again. They're trying to get the ball down low. Lichtenstein with it, stops, move, drop step, and gets it inside.
Yeah, that was a tough one. Jalabama got caught on the backside right there, and he got caught on the high side, matter of fact, which has allowed that backside under, up and under. And, you know, Jalabama's playing actually pretty good defense. I'd like to see him get a little bit more front side help, you know, push a little more, but you know, he may be staying in the framework of what the coach wants to do.
Absolutely. Dutash with the ball, gets the ball over to Ethan. Ethan's going to push the issue. Gets it out to Joel Obame, who's way out by the three-point line. McClure with it. He's going to take it inside with the left hand, and he's going to miss it, get knocked down. But Lichtenstein with some good defense. And here come the Owls. Three-pointer up and good.
Yeah, we're going to have to run these guys off this three-point line, Chuck. That's the third three that they've had that is pretty much an open look. And, you know, we're going to have to find these guys. We've got to know where 10's at. We've got to know where 3's at. And those guys, as we see that drive by Keezer.
That's the first time Kellen's gotten the ball inside like that. We need more of that from him.
Yes, we do. Yeah, he's just been a little, maybe he's just probing right now to find out what's going on. But we're going to need him to get in that scoring column.
22-12, Trailblazers down by 10. About 5 minutes left here before halftime. Again, Lichtenstein down low. Butash with the rebound. Lichtenstein, he's getting the ball entirely too low.
He is getting it too low. We're not making him work to get the ball. He's just pretty much just kind of setting up on that block and just sliding back and forth, and Jalabami's on his back. And anytime you're on the back, you see an unforced error by Keister right there. You can't be on the backside of the guy like that.
Yeah, that's what he's going to say. He stepped out of bounds on the drive.
Yeah.
See coach for the Owls telling his ball players just to slow it down. We're up. We're in no hurry.
If I'm not mistaken, I think the coach from the Owls is from Atchison, Kansas.
Yes, he is.
I want to say he played ball with the Downing boys up there, and Lance Greenlee, Warren Smith.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, we're going to have a timeout here. The Owls are just lighting it up from the outside. 30-second timeout. You know, as we mentioned earlier, the frigid weather has caused some havoc with the Trailblazers' schedule, forcing games to be rescheduled. So the boys' game with Leavenworth, originally scheduled for last Wednesday, has been moved to Monday the 22nd, with JV starting at 4, and the last girls' game, also against Leavenworth, has been moved to Tuesday the 23rd, with JV starting at 4 o'clock. But we'll see on the 23rd as well. Mm-hmm. The boys will play Olathe Northwest. And so coming down to crunch time, trying to make these games up before tournament season starts. But you can see all that action right here on MSTCSports.com.
You know, I'm pretty interested in that Tuesday game there, Chuck. Olathe Northwest, that's my son's old team. And I don't know if the old coach is still there, but we'll see if he's up to the same old game plan.
I know Tuesday night you get to work with Dr. Jones, Dr. Jarius Jones.
I don't know if the patrons are ready for that. That might be a whole different animal that night.
Well, I get the other Jones partner. I get Danae on Monday night.
Yeah, I don't think they're ready for that
so
either.
Trying to keep up with the Joneses. What can we say? And Ethan Johnny on the spot. Oh, actually, it's McClure Johnny on the spot.
He just happened to be in the right spot. And, you know, once again, that was a good pass in. Good pass inside. But once again, I would like to see a bounce pass down there.
Yeah.
Makes it a lot easier for the big fellas to grab it.
McClure trying to complete the three-point play. Free throw is up, and he knocks it down.
And that's much needed right there. It doesn't matter how we get three, just get three, Jake.
Puts the Owls up by 25-15. They lead by 10 over the Blazers. The Owls are very patient to throw the ball around the perimeter until they get the advantage that they're looking for. Mitch Mock is checking to the game, a little bigger body than Joel Obame.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to make Lichtenstein work hopefully a little bit harder. Good job by him.
I like that front side defense right there. Good.
Good job.
Good. Run, Ethan, run.
Here comes McClure off the glass.
I like it.
And here come the Owls. Now they're pushing the ball up the floor. We're trying to get back before the Trailblazers can get their defense set up. Lichtenstein comes across looking for the basketball. Didn't get it. Rotates the ball around. And we got another three. It's going to be Oh, that's what the shooters bounce.
The shooters bounce on the road. How do you get the shooters bounce on the road?
And I tell you, that causes the Olathe West Coast to call timeout. That's amazing. Well, we'll talk more about that when we come back. You're watching GEHS TV on MSTC Sports.
All right, everyone, we made it.
My job is to help new homeowners who have turned into their parents.
I'm having a big lunch and then just a snack for dinner.
So we're using a speakerphone in this store. Is that a good idea?
One of the ways I do that is to get them out of the home.
You're looking for a grout brush.
Did he ask for your help?
No.
We all see it.
He has blue hair.
Okay.
Blue.
Progressive can't protect you from becoming your parents, but we can protect your home and auto when you bundle with us.
Keep it coming.
You don't know him.
Welcome back to Gardner Edgerton High School. Chuck Holmes here with Coach Larry Fennell. Coach, we just saw a home team bounce go for the visiting team. You don't see that too often.
You don't see that very often where the visiting team gets a home team bounce.
That's amazing. So Trailblazers trailing 28-17 with about 3 minutes left here in the before halftime. And Jake almost throws the ball away, gets it to Buttash. Buttash stops, misses. Ethan's fighting for the rebound, and we're going to be a foul. That's going to be Ethan's third foul.
Yeah, that's a little tough one right there. Ethan just got caught on the back, and 9 times out of 10, they're going to call that foul on you, even if you don't touch him. You know, we see that a lot. You don't touch him. You know, that's one that Ethan might have backed out, but we said Ethan is aggressive.
That's right. He's not going to back
out
from
that ball. You cannot fault him for that.
That's right. So he has to take a seat probably until after halftime when Connor Elder checking in for him. Now, Lichtenstein way outside. Got a new body down low. Dennis with the basketball. Lichtenstein, he's looking. Little move. Gets to kick the ball back out. There's a free throw there. He goes up. Mitch. Doing
yeah,
a good
Mitch
job.
Played it right. Yeah. You know, Dorm's not trying to shoot the ball. And Mitch played. He paid him just right. And just.
Just, the guy just powered up and wanted it.
He just made a basket. Yep.
Right now, the only offense the Trailblazers have is McClure. And there's another steal. Here comes Dennis pushing the ball up the floor. 1-on-4. Misses the layup. Rebound, Buttash.
Yeah, it didn't seem like any of us or Trailblazers were trying to stop that ball as Dennis was coming through like a freight train.
Here comes Keeser. He comes in, throws it up, and he's fouled. We've got to have more of that from Keeser tonight.
Yeah, this afternoon. Yeah, we're going to need Keeser to get in there. And, you know, especially with Ethan sitting on the bench for 3 fouls, yeah. We're going to need him to take that role of putting pressure on the defense and getting into the paint. And Jake spotting up.
Yep.
You know, that's good. It's an inside-outside game. But, you know, there's some things we need to look at come halftime. And, you know, one thing is we got to run these guys off that line.
Kellen heats the first one. See, Keeser is driving the lane. He gets the foul on number 20. It's a two-shot foul. It's a 16th foul against the Owls.
It's a low foul game.
Yep.
You see that a lot when there's one team shooting a lot of threes, and you don't see a lot of fouls that way.
Yep. Almost 80%. And Joe Labame with a good hustle throws the ball out. And Connor Elder
good hustle
with the rebound. Malachi gave up his dribble. Now he needs some help. Jolabami cutting to the basket. Still more good hustle. Pushes the ball back outside. Connor Elder with the basketball. He gets Jake McClure cutting across the middle to stop. Turn around. Doesn't get it. Jolabami fighting for the rebound. Now it's coming away with it. Nice hands. Malachi Taylor. Gets the ball ahead to Jolabami, who's going to take it up and lay it
in. There we go. Good hands by Malachi. See, Dennis was trying to sneak it in, and that man was open down low, too. It was good hands.
Number 10 with the wide-open three. No good. Jolabami with the rebound. And here comes Keeser with the basketball. He's going to force the issue, and they're going to call a block on number 2 on Dennis.
Dennis wasn't set on that one, and Keeser helped himself out by sliding sideways, and the official rewarded Keeser.
Well, Keller's doing exactly what you said he has to do, Coach.
Yes. And so we see that replay right there. He slides across, and you know Dennis tried to get it with the Duke flop, but didn't. Was unsuccessful.
First free throw is up and good. Kellen almost 80% free throw shooter.
And we got to be able to score points when the clock's not running, as we've kind of cut into it now. We're down 9, and we were down 15. And
that's right.
So this is the way to do it. Just kind of keep chopping away. Can't get them all at once. There's no 9-point shot.
That's it.
Yeah, that's true.
3-point line keep moving on further. Who knows?
Yeah, that's true.
And Keller knocks down both of them. Trailblazers trail by 8. Came up on 40 seconds left here before halftime. Looks like the Owls going to play for the last shot, unless they get something really good. They don't seem to be in too much of a hurry. Passing the ball now. They pick up their offense a little bit. They're looking to ball fakes. See, Lichtenstein has moved towards the middle now. He's at the free throw line. They're going to try to get the ball inside of him or take a long 3-pointer.
Yeah, we just got to watch for 10 and 34 on this last shot.
There's 34. Lichtenstein way out short. We got to get the offensive rebound. And it's no good. Trailblazers got away with one right there.
Got away.
Getting boxed out. Hey, that brings us to halftime. The Owls from Olathe West currently lead 30-22 over our Trailblazers. We're going to be right back. Talk about more of it in halftime, Coach. We'll be right back after this message from GHS TV on MSTC Sports.
Whereas Kansas has a rich history as being a part of the Underground Railroad, a network of people who worked together to hide and transport freedom seekers on their journey north. And
whereas the Underground Railroad played a significant role in the elimination of slavery in the United States and was a foundation for future civil rights movements. And
whereas we are deeply motivated by the efforts of the courageous people who traveled the Underground Railroad and looked to Kansas as a gateway to freedom, as they have been a source of inspiration to generations of Americans. And
whereas Kansas has 29 counties who are part of the Freedom's Frontier National Heritage Area. And whereas the state is home to 21 Underground Railroad Network to Freedom sites managed by the National Park Service, which continue to tell the story about the nation's struggle for freedom that did not end with the Civil War. And
whereas, in appreciation of the efforts of those who manage and preserve the sites of the Underground Railroad in Kansas and those from around the world who have committed themselves to document and share the stories of the Underground Railroad and the enduring struggle for freedom in Kansas.
Now, therefore, I, Laura Kelly, Governor of the State of Kansas, do hereby proclaim September 2020 as National Underground Railroad Month in Kansas and ask all Kansans to join me in honoring those from our past who pursued freedom by traveling the Underground Railroad and in expressing gratitude for those who helped them on their way, and to join together to continue the fight for freedom and equality for everyone.
Trailblazers basketball here on GHS MSTC Sports. Had a very entertaining first half, Coach.
Very entertaining.
Running up and down the floor. We've got some highlights here for you guys. So, I mean, Jake McClure's been the one that's been instant offense for the Trailblazers so far.
Yeah, Jake is doing what Jake does. He knocks down the outside shot, and he's taken the ball in a few times and gotten in the paint and got it down. But, you know, we're gonna have to get on key number three to the game. We're going to play a little better defense, 3-point ball.
Exactly. You look at the Owls, they are just red hot from the outside.
Yes, they are. We see Jake knock, do what Jake do, knock shots down.
You're going to need some more information. You need some more help. But you see Lichtenstein from the Owls just getting down low and just abusing people down there, basically.
Yeah, he's just basically using his size and, you know, big boy moves down low. He's not doing a whole lot, but he's getting pretty good position on the blocks. And we got to get him off that block first and make life a little uncomfortable for him.
Indeed, as we looked at Jake taking one off the glass, but you know, as we mentioned earlier, the Owls are just red hot. They are not missing. Look at this. I mean, the three bouncer.
Yeah.
And that's the home team bouncer.
That's the home team bounce. Got it. How does he get a home team bounce
exactly.
In my gym?
Yeah, well, I don't know. Well, back to the keys. Fast break points. We don't have many.
We don't have very many because we're not the defense is okay, but we're not getting the Owls off of the three-point line, and they're knocking those shots down. So if you can't play defense and limit them to one shot, you can't get out and run.
Absolutely.
You can't get out and run. That you can't get Ethan the ball.
So true.
So, you know, those three keys all come together.
Okay, when they did get Ethan the ball, you know, Ethan's he's been effective, but now he's got saddled with three fouls.
He's got three fouls. He's going to have to be careful coming out in the third quarter.
Exactly.
Not to pick up that fourth one.
Got to play a little bit better defense. So
yes.
We'll talk a little bit more when we come back. After this break, you're watching GEHS-TV, MSTC Sports.
My job is to help new homeowners who have turned into their parents. I got into this because I was a sufferer. I turned into my dad, but I came back. And I'm here to help others come back. This is my baby right here, Dr. Rick, on Becoming Your Parents. It came about where my parentology thoughts, I was coming up with so many of them, I thought, I don't need to just have this, the world should have it. So I just birthed it, you know, right out of me. Sometimes we have a victory and I relish those.
Probably need a hacksaw at some point.
Nope, nope.
But most of the time we don't.
General rule of thumb, we throw pillows. If there's nowhere to sit, you have too many.
Parentology is not an officially recognized field yet, but I think we're making strides in that direction. You just have to keep reminding them, you are your own person. You're not your parents, you're you.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Adam Winters, the Kansas Highway Patrol. The Kansas Highway Patrol public resource officers across the great state of Kansas have a message for you.
Three out of every four car seats are installed incorrectly. Please read your owner's manual and vehicle manual to learn how to install your car seat correctly.
When driving on Kansas highways and you see a trooper in a safety vest and you see the orange cones, you're in a construction zone. Please remember, slow down, don't drive distracted, and move over. It's Kansas law.
Now that you've seen us, make sure you see us and all other first responders and road workers. Move over.
On behalf of everyone in our community and in healthcare, thank you for doing your part.
We appreciate your doing your part to keep us all safe.
When in public, stay 6 feet away from others.
Wash your hands often for at least 20 seconds with soap and water.
Wear a mask together. We are slowing the spread of this virus.
And together, we are saving lives.
At Children's Mercy, we know that trust is everything.
And you can trust that we will do whatever it takes to protect the health and safety of your child.
Especially now. So we put our plan into action, implementing safety measures at every step of the way.
Whether it's technology that allows you to see your doctor from home,
or carefully planning out every visit so you'll know what to expect.
Because we want you and your child to feel safe at our home, too.
Welcome to Garden, back to our Garden Anderson High School. And all this month has been Black History Month, and during each broadcast, we always try to recognize those that are involved with Black History Month and give a little bit of history on Black History Month. And, you know, I know we've heard this before, but, you know, it's always good to remind people in the Gardner-Edgerton Public School District is proud to join the nation in honoring Black History Month throughout the month of February, also known as National African American History Month. This annual celebration commemorates the contributions and achievements by Black Americans and serves as a time for recognizing the pivotal role of African Americans in the story of the United States of America. 1976, President Gerald Ford officially recognized Black History Month during the U.S. Bicentennial, expanding Negro History Week into a month-long celebration. He called upon the public to seize the opportunity to honor the too often neglected accomplishments of Black Americans in every area of endeavor throughout our history. And since then, U.S. presidents have designated February as Black History Month. The theme of Black History Month 2021 is the Black Family, Presentation, Identity, and Diversity, chosen by the Association for the Study of African American Life and History. And we mentioned before that Hindu Productions is a minority-owned company, family-owned company, and so people do know that we are diverse. We have a diverse crew here today. We have a young man down on camera four, and we'll look around and we'll see some of the other guys running the floor camera down there. And we got another guy up here He's just laughing because he knows he's about to be on television here. And there he is.
There he is. No place like home. Welcome
and,
back.
Yes, indeed. So we do practice diversity here with Hindu Productions. And they are also part of our family, if people really want to know.
Right.
They are part of our family as well. So thank you guys for everything you do. People on the truck, thank you so much. People here and running the cameras, you guys give up your Saturday to do this. Thank you so much. We appreciate that. I know Coach and I do for sure.
Yes.
So, hey, Coach, it's after halftime. Trailblazers are losing 30-22.
Yes.
What we need to do, man, to get back into this game?
Yeah, we're going to take a look at Jake here and look at his highlights. And, you know, Jake's going to be one of the keys to get us back in with his outside shooting. And, you know, the one thing we got to do is we're going to have to run the Owls off that three-point line. They've shown us that they can knock that shot down, and there's no sense of us allowing them to have that shot anymore. Let's run them off that line and make someone else beat us, you know.
You know, common sense will tell you, too, that they can't keep shooting threes as hot as they are shooting threes. They've got to be shooting close to 70% from the free throw line. And we see Jake knocking down a couple here. Here's Jake with a – you can't leave him by himself.
You cannot leave him by himself. He's going to knock that shot down.
Every time.
By himself every single time. You know, that's – it's just going to be the key right now.
Yep.
We just got to play better defense, get them off that line, and we got to knock some shots down ourselves.
Yeah.
You know, offense is kind of – it's a little stale. You know, last time we had the guys, they were clicking on all cylinders. And, you know, sometimes you see that.
Yep.
You have a real good game where you click on all cylinders and the next game is a little tougher. So nothing that the other team does, nothing that you do, it just happens.
Yeah, since we've had them last, they did beat Olathe South.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, even though they weren't – they clicked pretty well against Olathe South, but not like they did against Mill Valley. And they lost the game against Mill Valley, but that was probably the best ball game you and I have seen them play the entire season.
Yeah, I want to say that was their best all-around game that we saw in that Mill Valley game. It's unfortunate we lost that game, but that was a very good offensive game.
Yes, it was. Well, the Trailblazers are starting off defense. Ethan Reynolds, number two, is three personal fouls, so you expect the Owls to kind of go after him a little bit.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see if the Owls, you know, if Coach goes right after him. And Ethan's going to have to play smart. He wants to be aggressive, but he's going to play smart so he can stay on the floor.
One thing about the three-point shot, if you're hot, you're hot. You can hit it from anywhere on any end of the court. So we'll find out here if they're still hot from the three-point line from this end of the court.
Yeah, we'll see. Sometimes just change the scenery will throw your shot off a little bit.
Long offensive rebound by the Owls. They reset their offense. And good defense as the Owls throw the basketball away by Jake McClure putting pressure on the ball handler.
Yeah, that's going to be a good sequence right there if we can do that a couple more times and get ourselves back in. We're running down eight, so it's not insurmountable to make that happen.
Oh, it's early. Getting just after halftime, we got two whole quarters basically.
Yes, we do.
Two whole periods to play. Ethan with the basketball, still being aggressive, driving the ball inside. Kicks it over to McClure, who kicks it out there. Oh, and almost thrown away as Buttigieg wasn't looking for the pass. And we're going to have a traveling call on Ethan as he went in and lost his footing. He got his feet crossed up.
Yeah, it was just unfortunate that happens. But you know, don't stop the aggression, though.
That's right.
Got to continue to go after that, go at that rim. And get some buckets up here.
Dennis brings the ball up court, the former Trailblazer, now with the Owls from Olathe West. Long three-pointer by number 20. So far, they've missed two of their three-pointers from this end of the court.
Yeah, we'll see if they can maintain as Jake throws one up himself. And good job by Jala Barman not even putting his hand in there and picking up a cheap foul.
Owls going to try it again. 0 for 3 from this end. Dennis fighting for the rebound. Gets the ball, saves it. Back to the Owls. The weak side help by McClure, and the ball is thrown away.
I'll take it, Chuck. From coach's standpoint, I tell the young man, what are you throwing the ball around for? You on the low block, shoot the basketball.
Take the shot.
As a trailblazer, I'll take that.
Here comes Keiser. He's bringing the ball up the floor. Now. See if he can't get Kelvin in gear here. Kicks it out to Ethan. Ethan around to Buttigieg. Buttigieg to crossover, trying to find a little lane. Can't find one, gives up his dribble, needs a little help, and he takes a walk.
Yeah, we can't run away from the ball like that. If you see your man getting trapped down there, everybody needs to present themselves available for a pass, and We didn't have any of that. Everybody just kind of stood around and watched him and didn't go bail him out. Yeah, bail your teammate out when they get down in that corner like that.
And the Owls currently leading 30-22. Neither team has scored here yet after halftime. A scrum on the floor, and we're going to have the ball's out of bounds, going to belong to the Trailblazers. You see McClure trying to get his team fired up.
Yeah, we're a little flat right now. You know, Latham West is letting us get back in this game by not knocking shots down, and we seem to be just a little bit out of sync. We need a nice basket and one to get the crowd back into the game.
Out to Butash. Butash running offense. He's getting cut off, and there's a bounce pass, but just a little bit too hot for Keeser.
Just a little bit long on that bounce pass. It's a good look, though.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good look.
And both teams come out a little bit flat after halftime. We're almost 3 minutes in, and no one scored yet.
They might be wanting to get outside. You know, it's about 35 degrees, so, you know, it's shorts weather now.
Oh, yeah. Break out the beach umbrellas.
That's
you
right. That's right. Where the flip-flops at?
Dennis with the basketball, looking down low for Lichtenstein. Lichtenstein with the stop, move, throws the ball away. And here comes McClure. McClure pushing it, one on three. We're going to have a block. Oh, they're going to call an offensive foul. They're going to call an offensive foul on McClure on that, Coach. I know, settle down. Don't say it. Turn your mic off.
I'm trying not to say it, but it is Saturday morning or Saturday afternoon, and I'm sure Jay Billis is somewhere getting ready to call a basketball game. And that young man was not set, and Jay Billis would say it for the next 1 minute and 30 seconds on the clock.
Jake's first foul.
It was just unfortunate. He was not set. So, you know, it's unfortunate.
Butash battling down low, giving up some height. Back off in it. Peter and the men. We have missed every single shot they've taken this half and all been three-pointers. And it's going to be just a little bit too far. It's still a bummy. Still a bummy running to the wall. We're going to have a timeout on the floor as well. Coach, maybe we get another look at that charge.
Let's take a look at it. See if there. Let's see here. Oh, no, sir.
No, he wasn't set. He got there, but he wasn't set.
One thing that's important is you have to be set before you get. They say you don't have to be set.
That's true.
To be in legal position, but he was given ground up. And if you're given ground up and you're not set, it is not a charge.
Well, I promised the officials I would mention their name, but I'm not going to mention them on that call.
No. Everybody must know who made that call.
No, I'm just saying.
Jay Billis is not here, so I'm channeling his energy.
I'll give the men in stripes a break this time. I'll wait till they make a good call for the Trailblazers.
That's right.
Then I'll give them some love.
That's right. This is the Trailblazer Network. We are allowed to do that.
Yes, indeed. Until that time, forget about it.
You know, I got a little break here, Chuck. You know, I have a cousin and some friends that grew up in Atchison, Kansas, and they play ball with Coach Brad.
I thought he did.
Sent them a text, and they're all just firing up my text now. Call it this. Hey, we played Brad ball, and we called it five ball. And I said, man, we'll see if we can get it in. So shout out to the coach and his high school classmates who happen to be my friends as well. We're all old guys.
Another long three-pointer. And we're going to have a fighting on the floor. We got bodies flying everywhere. And Jillabami scrapes the boards clean after bodies were flying everywhere.
Yeah, we see both teams are now just, they're turning it up, trying to make a bucket. We need the team to score since we came out of halftime. And you know, we've had a lot of time come off that clock.
Jake is short on that three-pointer. I'll tell you what, though, we talked about the administration. They are letting them play a little bit.
They are letting them play, and I like that. I like that. Let the game be decided on the field by the players and not the officials.
That's indeed. And then Lichtenstein down low, rolling off the hip of Keeser, and he knocks down the first basket of the second half of either team.
That was good defense by Keeser. Lichtenstein's got some pretty good moves down there. He set him up pretty good, let him ride all the way across, then plant it.
Keeser comes down. Nobody stops him.
All right. Maybe he's helping for Larry.
Takes a little 12-pointer.
We went a good 5 minutes without a basket, and now we've got two baskets in 15 seconds.
Looks like Lichtenstein is now, Keeser is now working with Lichtenstein. Put a little bit more height on him. Move Jillabami out to the wing a little bit. They're fighting, working hard down low.
Yeah, I like to see him get across. I like to see him work a little harder.
That's a good job.
That's what I want to see right there. Get in front of him.
Get some weak side help on the other
side.
Now
reset yourself. There you go.
And they're going to be a foul on Jillabami for reaching in. Going to be on the floor.
Yeah, you give up defensive picking up your defensive position like that, that guy's going to always get across your body like that. And he does that, it's inevitable you're going to foul.
Well, actually, they called that foul on Buttash. I thought it may have been on Joe Bonney for reaching in, but they gave it to Buttash. That's his first. Team foul number two for the Trailblazers. Ethan's back in the game. And that's a cheap foul that they're going to call on Buttash.
That's unfortunate right there. He's in the right position. And, you know, you heard the crowd say ball. And when you're in that defensive position, you're not looking for the ball. You're playing the man's eyes.
Right.
Just got a little too close.
You know, it's kind of like a defensive back. You got to turn around and look for the ball.
Exactly.
Don't get the call. So.
Exactly.
Again, Owls inbound the ball in the backcourt. 2.5 minutes left here in the third quarter, third period. Another three-point shot by the Owls. They finally hit one.
They finally hit one. And then, you know, if you get that many good looks at some point, Chuck, you're going to knock one down. They had missed their last four and got another good wide open look and knocked that down.
Yes, indeed. Keesey with the basketball looking to take over. Gets the ball out to Buttash for the three. Just a little short. And here come the Owls. Ethan harassing the ball player, ball handler as he comes up the floor. And Ethan can't be too aggressive with that. He's got three fouls. So.
Yeah, he's doing all he can on that possession. So.
And we're going to have a full timeout here on the floor by the Trailblazers. We're going to talk more about the action, Coach, because it's starting to heat up a little bit. You're watching GEHS-TV on MSTC Sports.
We're at the movies and we need to silence our phone. Who knows where that button is?
I don't have silent.
Everyone does, right up here.
It happens to all of us. We buy a new home and we turn into our parents. What I do is help new homeowners overcome this.
Was that an adjustable spanner? Good choice, Steve.
Okay, don't forget, you're not assisting him. You hired him. You have nowhere to sit. You have too many. Who else reads books about submarines?
My dad.
Yeah.
Oh, those are...
Progressive can't protect you from becoming your parents, but we can protect your home and auto when you bundle with us.
Look at that.
Hitting that little gel, so.
And we're back here at Gardner-Edgerton High School. The Trailblazers currently trail 37-24, with just a little bit less than 2 minutes here in the third period. And Coach, Trailblazers came out ice cold from halftime.
Yeah, we saw both teams come out and not knock any shots down for about 5 minutes of game time. And all of a sudden, we saw a little flurry with two baskets back-to-back, 15 seconds. And, you know, then we finally saw Wes hit a three, and now we're back down 13 again. So,
yeah, we were wondering if that change of scenery for Wes on the three-point line would make a difference. And it, so far it had, but they knocked down one of probably six shots that they tried.
Yeah.
You know, so let's hopefully they can continue to shoot that terrible percentage and get the Trailblazers back into this game.
Yeah, we just have to run them off that line. We got to play better defense and not let them have those open looks like that.
Mitch Mock in now. Keeser thinks about it. Needs a little help. And he gets the ball out to Jake McClure. McClure over to Malachi. Malachi behind the back. Scoops it up. Gets it back over to McClure. He gets it out to Mitch. Mitch is way outside. Middle's open, so Keeser thinks about it, goes inside. He's going to make Lichtenstein do something. And
oh, nice.
Outstanding
that
ball handler.
Outstanding right there by Keeser. Outstanding. Yeah, him to sleep with the little crab dribble and went right by him.
He made Lichtenstein do something. Look at this. This is great ball handling and body control.
And
look
that
at
body
that.
Control was excellent.
80% free throw shooter at the line. Let's see if he can knock down, complete the three-point play, and he does.
I'm glad you didn't jinx him, Chuck.
Oh, hey, hey, hey. Hey, no, that's not me.
Oh, no trouble.
No, I don't dabble in witchcraft.
No side.
Trailblazers trail by 10, 37-27. Big three-point play by Keeser to get the Trailblazers within 10.
We need more of those there. Cut into this 10-point lead.
You can see they kind of.
Oh, he walked.
And he got away. No, he did not get away with the walk.
Sir,
good call, Coach.
Yeah, that is illegal right there. You cannot do that. It's in the rule books. That is cheating. Our ball.
Well, in that case, and I'll mention the referees out here. You know, one of the referees is Greg Abernathy. Then we got Miguel Cartagena.
Cartagena.
Cartagena with the call. And then Larry Stotts. Nice give and go. Back door. And McClure misses on the.
He needed a go-go gadget arm to get a little further out there.
Oh, nice ball fake and a nice pass. Oh, yeah, good hands. Oh, they're going to call the foul on McClure.
A little late with that whistle. Yeah. But that's okay. Yeah, it's just got it right. It was a foul.
We'll see two shot. We'll see it's a two-shot foul.
Take a look and see. Yeah, that's going to be a foul. Even though he got a lot of the ball, he got a lot of the arm as well. So it is a foul. He's got to earn these now. Not in giving. What's his percentage, Chuck?
Well, right now, 100%.
We got to give him a percentage. We got to try to jinx him.
That's his first free throw, I believe.
Oh, my goodness.
Let's see if we can. Like I said, I don't dabble in witchcraft, but I have been known to throw a spell or two on some people. I'll save it, though, for the end of the game.
There you go.
That's when we really need to miss them.
That's right.
Dick Stein checks out of the ball game after hitting those two free throws. And look, some little full court pressure here by the Owls as they try to slow down the Trailblazers.
Yeah, we'll have to stay out of the corners. And we saw in the JV game, the JV team ran that play and they did a jump trap.
Yep, and the ball is stolen away by the Owls. Just quickly get back. And the coach pulls him out, looking for the last shot. This is a pretext of what's to come, coach, in the fourth period. You know that, right?
Oh, yes.
If they got a 10-point lead, they're going to take the air out of the ball.
Yes, they are.
There's a three. Short. Jill Obama with the rebound, gets it out to McClure with the long, and just a little short. Well, coach, that does it for three. We're down 39-27. We got a whole fourth period to come back, so talk more about it when we come back. You're watching GEHS TV on MSTC Sports.
Food is life. It's the building blocks of our amazing bodies. Food is strength. It powers us in the pursuit of our full potential. Food is energy. It fuels our accomplishments, big and small. It nourishes us in mind, body, and spirit. Food is health, fitness, and our future. For freshness, selection, and low prices, Kansas City knows. Price Chopper.
All right, everyone, we made it.
My job is to help new homeowners who have turned into their parents.
I'm having a big lunch and then just a snack for
so
dinner.
We're using a speakerphone in this store. Is that a good idea?
One of the ways I do that is to get them out of the home.
You're looking for a grout brush.
Did he ask for your help?
No.
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 We all see it. We all see it.
He has blue hair.
Okay.
Blue. Progressive can't protect you from becoming your parents, but
keep
we can protect your home and auto when you bundle with us.
Keep it coming.
You don't know
him. We're back to Gardner Hinton High School where the Trailblazers currently trail the Owls from Olathe West, 39-27. Coach, got 8 minutes left to put a dent in this. The Owls have already cooled off from the three-point line. What do the Trailblazers need to do?
One, we need to continue to go. Drive the ball in, but I think at this point we need to start driving to look for the kick out to Jake or Kester to knock down some threes, but we still have to be aggressive and go at that rim, try to cut into this, but it's going to be important to play better defense. We've got to get these guys off the line because even though they've won one of seven from the three-point line is coming out of half, at any moment they can knock them down, so we got to get them off that line and make them drive the basketball. Just watching the game, we already know who the shooters are and who are not the shooters. So, you know, if we know that from just kind of watching this game here without a scouting report, then coach should know that as well. And we just got to find the shooters right now. And 34, get him off their block. He's down low now. And got to find 10 down here in the corner. And, you know, number 3 is floating around the opposite side. We know 32 is not going to take a shot, so there's no sense of playing him out there.
Nice. Turnaround move, box out. One of the things the Trailblazers cannot do is they cannot continue to miss these little inside shots.
Yeah.
They're getting in close and they're falling right and they're not able to knock them down.
Yes. Yeah. We got, you know, we can look at the clock right now. We know we're down. We need to play this at possession by possession. Good defense score, good defense score, good defense score. and we're right back in
there. As you mentioned earlier, there's no 9-point play. There's certainly no 12-point play.
No, sir.
So you got to do it one at a time. Keisha with the basketball, kicks it out to Ethan. Ethan did a good job of playing with three fouls, not to pick up that fourth foul in the third period. But don't want to lose any of his aggressiveness. And the ball is stolen away. Keisha was driving the lane. Quick hands by the Owls.
That's the one thing we can't have is unforced turnovers. And that doesn't allow us to put any points on the board and cut into this lead.
Empty trips down the floor.
It's a bad deal.
Yep.
But there's still time, you know. The three-point line changes a lot of things in basketball.
Yes, it does. You know, Jake this season knocked out one or two. And all of a sudden, we're back in this game.
Yes, sir.
Down low, Villabombi with the foul.
We just had that conversation. You know, as we're sitting here watching this, Chuck, and I just kind of watched Licton just kind of lazily slid back and forth along the baseline and just kind of lulled Villabombi to sleep. Mm-hmm. And he didn't know where he was at. And by the time he got back on the other side, he sealed him off. And it was a good entry pass. So
that's Villabombi's first foul. So he really hasn't been very aggressive down there with those guys. I mean, he could be a little bit, especially against Lichtenstein right here.
Yeah.
He can definitely be more aggressive against it now with only one foul. So
Lichtenstein's only taken the 1-3 that we've seen so far today. And most of his work has been down on a low block.
Yep. That's the 15th foul against the Trailblazers. Two more, and the Owls will be in the bonus. And Ethan gets the ball inside, looking for the foul. Didn't quite get one, but
we'll take that bucket.
That's right. Now we need to D up. If we know we get within that 3-minute range, they're going to take the air out of the ball. We're down to 5:45 right now. With the shot, three-pointer, no good. And over, Ethan out, rebounded down low. And he pulled the ball back out. And looking for a little, running a little offense. Good job by Ethan.
That's a good job.
Knocking the ball away. Uh-oh, Buttes is giving up his dribble. He needs some help.
Hey, that's that front side defense I've been asking for the whole game.
There's Jake. Jake knocks down a two-pointer. Outstanding right there. That's what we needed, Coach. We needed that in the worst way. Let's take a look at some of the upcoming events here. You can find it right here on GEHS YouTube channels. The Outstanding Administrators in Gardner, Kansas, wants to make sure that during the pandemic, parents and supporters of the Trailblazers didn't miss any action. So you can try. You can find us simply on YouTube, on your smart TV, mobile device, or computer. There you can watch action from the freshman teams to the varsity teams. So stay in touch with us right here on GEHS TV. You see the last two games here up on the screen, Coach. You got the boys rescheduled to the 22nd against Leavenworth. And then the other boys game, rescheduled to the 23rd against Olathe Northwest. And I believe the girls, their last game is coming up here next week as well. So more action coming up. Stay with us. It's getting to be crunch time. We're going to go off into the tournament time here pretty soon.
Yeah.
And, you know, we can't see if the Trailblazers can make a way into the regionals. I mean, everybody's going to be in the regionals, but if they can't make it to state here.
Can you make it to state, yeah.
Yes, indeed.
Get out of that regional.
Yes, indeed. So hopefully we're not going to be in the same regional with Lawrence. I think the other 15 teams are saying the same thing.
They're all saying the same thing. I'm trying to avoid
Lawrence.
The Chesty Lions.
Yes, indeed. Free State may be the only school that's not saying that.
Yeah, they might be. That's a little in-town rivalry.
Yeah, we were talking about the Twitter and Facebook. And you know what's flying between those two schools.
You know it is.
Yes, indeed. Trailblazers come out with some full court pressure, looks like. They're going to pressure the inbound. Make the Owls work to get the ball up court. Coming up on 5 minutes left here in this game.
Yeah, we're gonna have to get some stops and some scores. Cut into this lead and put a little pressure on the Owls. Right now, they don't have any pressure on them. 10-point lead, 5 minutes left to go in the game. They're really not looking to score early.
Mm-mm.
Looking to take some of the air out of the ball. And
really not sure what type of free throw shooting team they are. Don't know if I'd be afraid to put them on the line or not.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure without us getting any notes from their school to understand what their shooting is. We do know that this young man with the ball here is not taking an outside shot.
He's not even thinking about taking a shot.
There's no need for Mitch to come out there and play him at all.
No.
Other than try to force him to get the ball out of his hands.
And that's what he wants Mitch to do, to come out there.
Yeah.
That's what he wants Mitch to do, to come out there and play him.
Yeah, and that's the thing, as we see Coach over there, Coach is just telling him to back off a little bit. And he's been saying that all day, and obviously now we know why. He's back off and make him shoot.
Ethan's giving up his dribble. He gets the ball outside. McClure with the basketball, gets it over to Ethan. Trailblazers just can't afford to waste too much time on the clock. Ethan goes in. He's going to be missed the shot, and the ball's going to belong to the Trailblazers. The ball is off the Owls.
Yeah, that was a good baseline drive by Ethan. He just came up a little short on that.
Yep.
Kind of happens at that angle sometimes. You come floating back across, and you don't get the ball high enough on the square. And gets trapped on the side of the rim.
Ball's going to be out of bounds off one of the aisles as well. It's getting to that point, Coach, where 2 points is not going to do it for you. You have to start looking at those threes.
Yeah, you have to start looking at threes or start looking at and ones driving to the bucket. But what's important is you're going to have to make stops on the defensive side first. So you got to score on your side and then stop them on the other side. And
Ethan flashing across the middle. Eight-footer.
Cut through, and Ethan doing what Ethan does.
Down by 10. Just about a little bit less than 4 minutes. And you put pressure on them. They can afford to do it. They can afford to do it.
Yep. We might want to test him. We got a lot of fouls left to give here, so.
Well, they got 5 team fouls, so they got at least 2 more to give up. We're gonna have a jump ball right there. And we're gonna have a technical foul on Gutierrez. Oh.
Yeah, I understand the call, but I don't like it. It's a good defensive play. Just a little emotion.
Yeah, you gotta let the kids have a little bit of emotion playing.
Yeah, let them have a little emotion.
We're gonna see this. Vutas does a really good job of tying up the ball handler.
They're talking about it. Let's see if it's,
he's here. He does a good job.
Yeah,
there's your jump ball.
No technical there. It was the. Yeah.
And he calls a technical foul on Vutas.
Yeah, I'm not, you know.
I don't know. You know, you got to let the kids have a little bit of emotion while they're playing.
You got to have some emotion. That was a good defensive play with the tie-up to get the ball back, to take it your way. You get up off the ground, and he was looking away from the young man. So, you know, if you're looking away from him, I'm going to let you go.
He may have said something when he first got up. But
yeah, we can't hear it up here.
We can't hear it up here.
With the headphones on and the distance we are. So we'll take a look at this. Look at it again and see if we can kind of determine what happened. It's good defense, first of all. You know, you put the ball out there, I'm going to take it.
Right.
Good defense. He gets up, and we don't know if there was something said right there. And
I know he looked at him, but I don't know if he said anything or not.
Yeah.
But just the look, probably. I don't know. You know, I said something nice about the men in stripes. I'm going to take it back. They blew it. I meant to take it back. Man, I tell you.
Yeah, it's... That's just unfortunate right there. It was a good play, and you know, if you have a football helmet on.
I mean, this type of play hurts, because not only do they not get the basketball, they give up 2 points, and then the Owls get the ball right back.
Get the ball exactly.
Yeah, so Olabami being aggressive, and we're gonna have nothing, no call. But the Trailblazers are trying to pick up the defense. 3 minutes left here almost.
This is the time where you're in scramble mode and
it goes right on by, and here comes Keeser. Pushing the ball off the floor. Loses the basketball. Joel Obama picks it up. McClure almost thought about it. And here comes Ethan with the little one-hander.
Ethan doing what Ethan does, getting that paint.
Trailblazers picking up the pressure on the defensive end.
Yeah, this is where we got to get a steal. And you know, if you don't get it early, it's close to 5 seconds.
We're gonna have a timeout.
Coach got it. Got timeout.
By West. From Olathe, the Trailblazers is picking up the intensity on the defensive end. Coach is getting exciting. We're down by 10.
Yes.
2:40 left in the game. We'll be right back. You're watching GEHS-TV on MSTC Sports.
On behalf of everyone in our community and in healthcare, thank you for doing your part.
We appreciate your doing your part to keep us all safe.
When in public, stay 6 feet away from others.
Wash your hands often for at least 20 seconds with soap and water.
Wear a mask. Together, we are slowing the spread of this virus.
And together, we are saving lives.
You get a technical foul. Welcome back to GEHS TV, MSTC Sports, where we're watching the Trailblazers currently trail the Owls 46-36 with about 2:46 left here in the fourth period. Coach is going to get excited here as we run up and down the floor. Trailblazers got penalized for showing a little bit of emotion there, which you and I, you know, they're kids.
Yes.
Let them play. Nothing was said. Nothing vulgar was said. I mean, he looked at him and
he actually gave his own teammate Kessler. Yeah. You know. Kessler congratulated him on the great play, and you know, we don't know what was said, but play athletics. It's an emotional deal.
I know, man. They're trying. Every game is important now.
Yes, very important right now. They're all important. So here's where we got to turn it up here, Chuck. We got to make a defensive stop, get the ball back, and score.
That's indeed here. Joe Obama guarding the ball player. Ball handler as he brings it up. A little quickness goes by. Almost thrown away, but able to stick to it. And here we go. As watching the Owls deflate the basketball a little bit. Mm-hmm. Oh, kind of held it with a great play from behind. Here comes Keister driving the ball up. 1-on-3, takes it to the hole, and he knocks it down.
Here we go.
Lichtenstein wants the basketball, gets the ball inbound. No quick hands. Here comes Dennis with the basketball. Gives it off, and no, he's not looking to shoot. They're going to pull the ball back out. A little less than 2 minutes.
Around a little clock here, so.
Needs more quick hands. Coach has fouls to give, and that's fine. That's one foul closer to footing it. Well, they actually will put them in the 1-1.
1-1 now. Now we'll see if the Owls can make some free throws.
What kind of free throw shooters they are coming up here? You see Keister, his hair back, driving the lane.
That means he's running fast.
What's the term? Like he's running with his hair on fire.
He's running with the hair on fire. Running fast. Going somewhere swiftly.
Look at the Owls. There's no one on the free throw line for the Owls. No one on the line. It's 1-1. You see, this might be their best free throw shooter. They want him with the ball in his hands.
So. Must be the best free throw shooter. Doesn't want to pick up any cheap fouls down there and allow us to take shots with no clock.
So, you know, not to get the ball to number 3. Now, here they're going to come with a little pressure to force the Trailblazers to use some clock bringing the ball up. Keister with the basketball. Looking to work it. He goes back inside again. And we're going to have a foul on the floor. That's only the 13th foul against the Owls, so. They got a lot of fouls to give before the Trailblazers could even think of, even sniff the 1-1.
Yeah, at this point, I would be using them. I would be telling my team, foul them on the ground. Do not allow them to get an and one. We have 4 fouls to go before it's a 1-1, so we can run clock off.
Here comes Ethan. The baseline gets the ball outside. There's Connor Elder for the 3.
There it is. Make a stop right here.
Putting some pressure on. That's the guy. That's the guy the Owls went with the basketball. Now you got Dennis with the basketball. That's the guy you don't want with the basketball if you're the Trailblazers. And the ball's knocked away, and it's going to belong to the Trailblazers. As the ball's knocked away off the Owls player.
Yeah, I'd like to see that. Does that ball roll off of the Owls?
I think it just rolled off his leg. Yeah, 1 minute left, and the Trailblazers are down by 7.
Quick basket right here. And there's the
Jake
guy
with the 3. Short.
A little short.
Rebound by Ethan. Ethan spinning around. Kicks it out. There's Keister with the 3. Yes!
All right. There you go. Coach. That's what you need right there, Chuck. So,
Coach, you got a ball game.
Yeah, we got to see if the Owls can make free throws. We're still down 4. We'll see what happens here.
Yes, indeed. That was outstanding ball movement, outstanding shot. Ethan working hard to get the ball outside. To get the rebound and push it back outside. So outstanding. You know, we call this year game on Saturday, Coach, but hey, you know, and that's because of all the frigid weather we've had. It's caused some serious havoc with the Trailblazers.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it's forced the games to be rescheduled. And you look at the boys' games here with Leavenworth, originally scheduled for last Wednesday, been moved to the 22nd. which is Monday night, and then with JV starting at 4 o'clock. And then on the 23rd, the boys would run off against Olathe Northwest, and you're familiar with the Olathe Northwest team. So
yeah, I'm quite familiar with them.
Yeah, so the cold weather has caused some havoc, and hopefully the Trailblazers will be hot for those last two games.
Yeah, I would definitely like to see them hot for that last one, that's for sure.
So I think the girls' last game is coming up too as well, so mm-hmm. they may be on for, I'm not sure what night they're on. I know one of us is working them, so.
Yeah, they're okay. on the road, so it won't like, be us on that one. I'll be back on Monday and Tuesday.
Okay.
So.
Well, it looks like the girls are going to be on the road for the rest of the season.
Yep.
So we won't see them anymore here for a while. And the boys will finish up here, so.
Right now, Chuck, we need to deny, and as soon as whoever touches the ball, foul it.
Exactly. It doesn't matter who.
The clock is against us right now, and we're down on the score. You got to play a tough defense and watch the runouts. There you go. Foul. You got to stop that clock.
You don't mind fouling this guy here.
No.
That's the guy you don't want with the basketball.
You do not want to foul him.
You don't want him with the ball.
You want to foul 11. I haven't seen him take a shot on him from the free throw line. So let's put somebody who hasn't taken a shot yet.
I agree.
Put him on that line. But that was too much time went off that clock. You got to deny. And as soon as that ball gets in, foul right there.
Yep.
Stop that clock. The clock's against you.
Yeah, that's the 18th foul. Two more than the Owls will be in the double bonus. Tulabame checking out.
You know, close games are won or lost from the free throw line.
Yes, indeed.
You see it all the time.
I'm telling you, this is the guy, he's your free throw shooter.
Yeah, he walked to the line with
total
confidence. A lot of confidence. There was no confidence and went through his routine and he knocked it down.
And he misses. Way to go, coach.
Hey, that's what we do. You said to hold it to the end of the game. We need a basket right here.
Keisha, nobody going to stop him. He's going to take him to the left. And he misses the easy layup. Oh, that would have. I think he expected contact and he didn't get it.
Yeah, that's a tough one, too, because when you expect contact, you are adjusting for that contact. And he just. We see. That's another thing that you see a lot. You know, you're expecting that contact. You see, it's a good. Good pick, and he expected somebody to hit him, and they did not.
And they did
just kind of threw him off. Well, we asked for it, Chuck, and now we're going to see if this young man can knock down a free throw. We hadn't seen him shoot one yet, so let's see what happens.
Still in the 1-1.
Yeah, okay. Sorry, fella.
Work your voodoo, man.
Yeah, well, I tried, man. I'm not a voodoo expert.
Well, go do that voodoo that you do so well.
That would be Headley.
Yeah. There you go. Trailblazers, 20 seconds left, down by 6. Quick hands, Jake with the basketball again. And we're gonna be, and he's gonna be stripped. And he gets the ball back, and the basket, and the one shot. All right, outstanding.
That's just unfortunate, but I'll take it because I'm the Trailblazers guy.
I'll tell you what, 3 points is three points anyway. Good hustle by Jake McClure to stay with the basketball, though. Good hustle by him. He gets it. He's outside. He's driving inside. Gets slapped. Gets the ball away. Kicks it with himself and kicks it back.
Incidental contact. So we'll take it.
Now, Jake.
We'll take it. Let's knock it down, Jake.
Another close to 85% free throw shooter, and he knocks it down. The Trailblazers is down by 3 with 13 seconds left to play here.
Tough defense. Foul immediately. Tough defense. Foul immediately.
Watch the long pass. Next time with the basketball, running up court. And he's going to Dennis. And he gets away with the walk.
He did.
And he got to call a foul on. Oh, man.
Sometimes the sequence is not in your favor. We're going to take a look and see how Dennis got away with that.
Throws the ball all the way across court.
Oh, then he almost threw that one away as well.
And he does. And they're going to call the foul on Buttash.
The hand is part of the ball.
Well, you know, the men in stripes, they're doing their job.
Yeah.
We got a quick timeout here. This coach from West wants to talk, set up his defense. Trailblazers down by 4. Two possession game. No, about 4.5 seconds left, Coach, and we call that a miracle. Oh, we got Madeline Christian. Oh, you know, I forgot about Madeline right here. I got to talk about Madeline this year. She did a wonderful job here. Let me pull her information up on the screen. And there she is. She's a freshman, and she was recognized by the New York Times. For what, you may ask? Well, Madeline Christian placed as one of the 20 runner-ups in the New York Times 15-second vocabulary video contest. Her delightful creative entry for the word. Oh, you got to be kidding me with this word, right?
Transmogriffy,
I guess, was selected from more than 1,500 submissions from around the world. Her submission was created as an assignment for ABPF Fall 2020. So congratulations, Madeline Christian, for something that I have no idea what it is.
Well, yeah.
Because I'm a baby boomer, so those words weren't even invented when I was a kid.
Well, they tell you, Chuck, you're supposed to find another word every day to learn, and I guess I have one I got to go look up when I get home. I understand what that is.
I've never heard that before,
I've
but okay.
I've never heard it, but apparently it won an award.
Out of how many entries from around the world? 1,500 submissions.
1,500. Congratulations.
Congratulations. Wow.
Yes, that's outstanding.
Did he say he stepped over the line?
Oh, Jake, whoa. It happens.
Yeah.
He was wanting to pass somewhere else, and the defender kind of ran towards Kiesler, and he saw it the last moment. Yep. He was already leaning.
So here we go, and this is going to do it right here. The Owls are going to walk out of here out of Gardner with a hard-fought 5-point victory. They beat the Trailblazers 52-47. One of those games, Coach, you know, but we got two more to go. We'll talk a little bit more about it when we come back, man. You're watching GEHS-TV on MSCC Sports. High School, where the Trailblazers have just fallen to the Owls from Olathe West, 52-47. And Coach, they continue to have their win-lose. So that means that Monday night, they should win.
They should win.
Really, you know. And today we're talking about the crew. We showed them on video and stuff. We got to thank the executive producer Todd Henderson, director Mike Ramos. Mm-hmm. Replay was Chris Wright. Graphics was Dominique Henderson. And on sound was Darrell Ramsey. Mm-hmm. On cameras, we have Chris Alt, Devin Sorrell, Vin Ryu, and Michael Davis.
That's right.
And so, you know, we're going to go to some highlights here real quick, too, because we need to get out of here because executive producer said he's buying breakfast.
That's right.
So we're going to go through some of these highlights here real quick. Actually, let's look at the play of the game first.
That's right.
Okay, and then we'll go. So here's the play of the game.
Let's look at this.
You know, I think it's Keller.
That's an excellent play.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Body control, split the defense, and one. That was excellent play right there. As a matter of fact, we needed that at that point.
Yeah. So now, that was one of the highlights that we saw. That was actually the play of the game. We had a number of highlights.
Mm-hmm.
Just didn't have enough for the Trailblazers, but we had a number of really good highlights. As we see here, Jake McClure drives in.
And then Ethan playing hard right down through here, and then Joe Labami sweeping the board.
Nice rebound.
Once again, we just watched Lichtenstein.
Lichtenstein, yeah, he did a lot of work down there in that paint. Hurt us.
Yeah, for a while there. I mean, from the first half anyway, the Owls were red hot from outside. They really cooled off in the second half, but the Trailblazers couldn't take advantage of it.
Yeah, we just could not get a shot, and there were some untimely turnovers and untimely calls against us, and the technical foul kind of really hurt us a little bit at that point, too, as well. And
yeah.
But that's part of the game.
Yeah.
You know, those things you have to overcome.
Well, Ethan Reynolds did a good job. I mean, once he picked up his third foul in the second period, he played pretty much. He didn't lose much aggression.
Yeah.
He didn't pick up any more fouls and stuff as he went in there either. But the Owls never really did back off when it came to shooting the ball inside.
No.
So, you know, Coach, it's been fun, man. I think this is the last time I'll be working with you.
This is the last time?
We're going to break up the Jones team for the next two games or whatever and stuff. So you get Dr. Jones and I'll get Danae Jones.
Yeah.
And we'll see if we can't match the same energy because I get to work with the women. You get to work with the doctor.
Yeah, the doctor is, well, I tell you so, it's going to be something else, me and the doctor on the mic at the same time. I'm not quite sure how that game's going to go.
Well, we want to thank you guys for joining us here today on this Saturday afternoon. Stay warm. Get outside because it's supposed to be sunny and at least in the 30s. And tell your friends, check out the ball game. We're still here. So thank you for watching. You've been watching Gardner Edgerton Trailblazer Basketball on GEHS-TV. On MSTC Sports. Peace out.